Hi, I'm Kieran McKee. Welcome to my channel on scientific writing. Today I'm going to be talking about how to write an abstract. One of my first videos on this channel provided a simple formula for writing abstracts. In this video, I'm going to dissect a couple of abstracts to show you the steps involved in crafting an abstract. An abstract provides a brief overview of your paper and appears before the introduction, as you see in this example. Some authors fail to put sufficient time and effort into preparing the abstract. When I first began writing, I didn't recognize how important the abstract was and just dashed one off using sentences copied from the narrative. Only much later did I understand that I should put an effort into crafting a unique passage that attracts readers to my papers. Essentially, an abstract should reflect all the parts of your paper, but in shortened form. In other words, a person reading only your abstract should be able to understand why you conducted the study, how you conducted it, what you found, and why your work is important. These 4 points provide a template for writing your abstract. Let's look at this example. In this abstract, the first 3 sentences give a brief background and explain why I conducted the study. Habitat stability of coastal ecosystems such as marshes and mangroves depends on maintenance of soil elevations relative to sea level. Many such systems are characterized by limited mineral sedimentation and/or rapid subsidence, and are consequently dependent upon accumulation of organic matter to maintain elevations. However, little information exists regarding the contribution of specific biological processes to vertical accretion and elevation change. These 3 sentences provide the justification for the study. The next section describes how I conducted the study. This study used biogenic mangrove systems in carbonate settings in Belize and southwest Florida to examine biophysical controls on elevation change. Rates of elevation change, vertical accretion, benthic mat formation, and below ground root accumulation were measured in fringe, basin, scrub, and dwarf forest types, plus a restored forest. Note that the study approach and methods are broadly described here. You don't need to go into detail about the methodology unless it's novel or the focus of your study. The next section, the longest, shows what I found. In this case, I had enough space to include data. Pause the video to read this section. The last section should describe what you conclude based on these findings, why the work is important, and/or the broader implications. This study indicates that biotic processes of root production and benthic mat formation are important controls on accretion and elevation change in mangrove ecosystems common to the Caribbean region. Quantification of specific biological controls on elevation provides better insight into how sustainability of such systems might be influenced by global and local factors affecting organic matter accumulation in addition to relative sea level rise. In this example, I provided a conclusion based on the results and the broader implications of these findings. Sometimes the word limit necessitates cutting down the information to include. In such cases, you may have to limit the results to the most important finding. You may also need more concise wording to cut down on verbiage. In this example, the reason for the study is given in 1 sentence. Although hurricanes can damage or destroy coastal wetlands, they may play a beneficial role in reinvigorating marshes by delivering sediments that raise soil elevations and stimulate organic matter production. Then the results are described in a way that includes the location and timing of the study and what analyses were conducted, obviating the need for a separate method segment. Pause the video to read this section. The abstract ends with the conclusions and implications of the study. Results of this study imply that hurricane sediment may benefit subsiding marshes by slowing elevation loss. However, Long-term effects of hurricane sediment on elevation dynamics will depend not only on the amount of sediment deposited, but on sediment texture and resistance to compaction, as well as on changes in organic matter accumulation in the years following the hurricane. This abstract contained only 241 words, but still provided a solid overview of the study. In writing your abstract, you want to provide enough information for readers to understand why your study was needed, how you conducted it, what you found, and why it's important. You also want to pique the reader's curiosity and make them want to read the rest of your paper. As always, examine the papers published in your target journal and see how their abstracts are structured. By following the guidelines covered in this video, you should be able to write a concise abstract that conveys the essence of your study. I hope you found this video helpful. Thanks for watching.